I'm here with the legendary champion, the Hall of Famer, the icon, one of the best to ever lace him up, Roy Jones Jr. Hey Roy, what's your thoughts on Crawford versus Errol Spence fight, man? Who wins that fight, and can you break it down for us?
I'm gonna say win, because like they say, Errol is a pressure cooker. We're gonna get better as the fight goes on. Terrence is a good fighter from the start, but like they say, sometimes he likes to wait and figure out before he gets started too. I'm gonna take it, sir. So, how quick he starts, and how quick Earl gets started, is what will determine how the fight goes. The first fight could end in a draw, because both of them are very smart guys. And the way they fight, their styles are kind of opposite, because one gets warm and picks you up, the others just start cooking. And he don't give a damn what it is, he's cooking anyway. So, when you know that, you got nothing. That's a good damn fight on paper. And I can't wait to see it. Can't tell you who might win, don't know why, but I like Crawford's chances earlier than I like Earl's, but as the fight get on, I like Earl's chances better because Earl is a person.
Hey, listen, we got a couple more fights. Come on, just a couple more predictions from you, man. We got Gervonta Davis versus Ryan. You know what I'm saying? Like, what do you say to that?
Has the fight been made yet?
Huh?
Has it been made yet?
I'm not sure, but I'm saying,
I don't think it's been made, so no sense to talk about it to get made, but that's a damn good fight too.
Okay, let's say like Bivol versus Gilberto Ramirez.
I like Bivol, but Ramirez is definitely a formidable opponent. Nobody beat him yet. He was a 68-pound champ. Tough. Mexican coming to fight. It's a good damn fight.
Alright. Fury versus Joshua, if it happens.
If it happens, everybody believe in Fury. I can count them too. Unless that fight against Bivol hurt Joshua enough and he wanna go get serious about it and come win for real. Because nothing harder to stop than a determined man. But a determined man wanna turn something around and get serious about it, he can become a problem.
Wow. So Fury fought Usyk. Who do you think, you know, who you favor to win in that?
Good big man beats a good little man. Until they change it, a good big man beats a good little man.
Okay, if Devin is successful in his next fight, if he wins, you know what I'm saying, who do you think will win between Devin and Lomachenko?
That's a tough fight to call. Devin is the younger guy, the bigger guy. Lomachenko has experience, and the older guy, so they kind of neutralize each other out as far as outside the ring. So in the ring, we have to figure out who can be, when did they meet Cam. Lomachenko be elusive enough, stay away from Devin and score to win the fight, or if Devin be powerful enough and explosive enough to catch him and hurt him and make him stay away, like Lopez did.
Okay, we got, let's switch gears to the night, man. We got a great fight tonight. We got Canelo versus Triple G. What do you have in that one?
I love both fighters. I think Triple G is more motivated than Canelo, but that's yet to be seen. But like I said, motivated guys for the start. Canelo is motivated for that last loss. He can be a problem. But we know Triple G is motivated because he didn't want to beat Canelo for the longest time. He feel like he'd beat him once or twice already and got the city. So we know he motivated and that's the only rival Triple G has, Canelo. Canelo got a world full of rivals. Triple G ain't got nobody but Canelo. So, tough to deal with.
If Canelo do win, who do you want to see him fight next?
Gonna be there. Who don't want to see that? Come on, bro. Everybody already know that.
Well, speaking of that, it's like, you know, what's your thoughts on Canelo saying he won't, you know, fight any Mexican fighters?
I already said my thought about that. When you boxing, you box. This ain't no national thing. You ain't amateur no more. You ain't on your national team no more. And even on your national team, you got to beat your people to get number one on your national team to represent your team. To make your living, I got to beat a lot of Americans to make your living. So don't tell me that now all of a sudden we get paid for, oh, I don't want to fight no American. Well, who the hell am I fighting?
That's facts. So why do you think Canelo, why do you think Canelo fought Chavez Jr., Angelo, and Lopez, but he doesn't want to fight Benavidez or Gilberto Ramirez?
I don't believe he don't want to fight Ramirez. I think he's just trying to use that as a marketing ploy or device to get his way on the negotiation table, which is smart. Yeah. I say I don't want it because I did that once. When I fought Reggie Jones, I kept telling him I don't want to fight Reggie Jones because my dad is training. Bullshit, I can't wait to fight him. But I didn't tell him that because I need them to give me the money right?
Yeah.
The money right, I bought it, but I can't say I didn't want to. That could be what I'm doing, because you fought Charlie and Junior. I can't say I don't fight next to you.
Yeah, so because Benavidez is mandatory. So what should PBC or WBC do about this situation?
You gonna fight or you get stripped? Something like that.
Right.
Same thing you always do.
Right. Thanks, Roy.
All right.